Hi, I'm Sharon, and welcome to my channel. The last couple of days, I've been dealing with the dreaded self-doubt monster, and I thought I'd come on and do a quick video and talk about some of the things that I do and some of the strategies I have for working through that part of the creative process and getting my mojo back. So, after decades of art and craft practice, and just to me, it doesn't matter how far I've come with my art, how happy I am with how far I've come, and how happy I am with a lot of the projects that I finish. I still experience this from time to time, and I'm sure I'm not alone. Some of you may be aware that in 2014, I created an oracle deck, and I then expanded on it and remade the cards in a couple of years ago. So my project for the last month or so has been to redo the project, to redo it. My focus has been on getting my deck to the point where it can go to print. Anyway, details of the deck is not the point of this video, and I will do an update video in sometime in the future. But for now, I wanted to talk about yesterday. So yesterday, after days and days and days of only focusing on this particular project, I hit a wall. And I hit a wall because I started looking and really deeply researching other people's work. And I started judging my deck and my work as not as good. So when that happens, what I find is that I just have to turn away from it all and do something else. So I packed it all up, and these are what I keep. These are what I use for my projects. I love these project boxes. So I packed everything to do with the oracle up into this box and put it aside. I don't know when I'll get back to it. It'll probably be in the next couple of days or so. But at the moment, I just knew that I had to take a break, or I was just going to get nowhere with it. So, that's my number one suggestion. If you're hitting a wall with a particular project, or you're just not feeling it anymore, step away. It's the first and most important thing that you can do is just step away from it and take time to just do something else. It doesn't matter what it is. Often I'll step away and I'll go and do something as mundane as vacuuming or doing a bit of housework. So it doesn't have to be stepping away from it and doing something creative, but you do need to step away from it and get some distance. So the other thing that I did today, and that's another thing that I'm currently in summer here in Australia, and where I live is usually stinking hot and really, really humid, and not a time for me to be doing much in my studio because it's like a sauna. So when I'm dealing with limited time for doing things in the studio, and I'm feeling creative, and I get a break. Like today, I've got a break. It's very, very cool in the studio today, so it's a great opportunity to get something creative done. So what I do in that case is I come in and I do what I call prep work. So when it can take all sorts of different forms. But at the moment, one of the things that I've been doing is, whoops, sorry, I'll just show you. One of the things I've been doing is prepping watercolor sheets for when I'm feeling in that creative space again, and ready and to do some actual art, some really, really creative artwork. This is what I call prep. It's painting the backs, and that's what I did today, painting backs of watercolor sheets, because I found that really helps to lessen the curling when I do a lot of painting, etc., on the front. Painting the back first really helps it to stop from curling. And then I do some collage like this. And this is just sitting, standing there at my desk and doing some random pieces of collage. And then the final stage is gessoing, giving the collage a light gesso. So to me, that's prep work. And when I'm ready and really, really in the mood to get into this particular project, this is another, not the Oracle itself. This is another project I had on the back burner. So I know that when I've got some good time in my studio, that I have all of these prepped and ready to go and ready to have some fun with. The other thing you might like to do is some prep work in your art journal, like prep some backgrounds. If art journaling is something you do, spend some time doing some quick backgrounds. These took me no time at all. And this is what I do a lot. I rarely, rarely do a journaling page from scratch. I do them in stages. Like I do a little bit of, if I've got a bit of paint left over, open to a page in my journal and brayer it on or paint it on. So that's another thing that you can do, a suggestion. Something else I do quite often is I do, these have been pre-cut from file folders. And I collage those and make them into journals. And that's just random collage. And I use these for lots and lots of things. And I will be, keep an eye out, I will be doing a video on these in the future. One of the other things I do sometimes is I go through my collage papers and my collage images and either tidy them up, go through and tidy them all up and pass on some that I'm not feeling I'll use, or pulling some out that I want for a possible project in the future. So there's just so many things that you can do when you hit that wall that says, I really don't feel like doing any creative, really creative stuff today, but you want to do something. Yeah, so do something practical, something grounding, something that's not going to feed that self-criticism monster. Remember, no matter who you are and how far you've come, creativity ebbs and flows. And it does come in waves and definitely goes through stages. I think that's another important part of the creative process, is to recognize your stages and look at ways that work for you. So I hope this has been helpful. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and I'll see you in future videos. Thanks for watching, and bye for now.